7. Islam is a way of life for every aspect in life, and thus democracies and free speech should be eliminated. It is true that Islam is a way of life and organizes each aspect of living, but it is not true at all that Islam seeks to cancel democracies or is against free speech. How can it be true if many of the principles of democracy are the same principles taught in the Quran, such as justice, human rights, looking after minorities and weaker sections of society? Also, taking into consideration that Islam makes charity, called zakat, mandatory for Muslims. The Quran, chapter 4, verse 135. O you who believe, stand out firmly for justice, as witnesses to Allah, even though it be against yourselves or your parents or your kin, be he rich or poor. Allah is a better protector to both, so follow not the lusts of your hearts, lest you may avoid justice. Freedom of religion, the Quran, chapter 2, verse 256. There shall be no compulsion in religion. The right way is now distinct from the wrong way. Anyone who denounces the devil and believes in God has grasped the strongest bond, one that never breaks. God is all-hearer, omnipotent. All intellectuals agree that freedom of speech has its limits. For example, I cannot abuse my neighbor's mother or wife, simply claiming freedom of speech. Similarly, Islam allows freedom of speech provided it supports truth and justice. Indeed, freedom of speech and faith is guaranteed in Islam. Unless a person will harm innocent people by his freedom of speech, then he is held accountable for his words. The freedom is there as long as you do not harm others. In this sense, we can say that insulting other human beings, prophets, burning their divine books is indeed not freedom, but against freedom. 8. Sharia commands that drinkers and gamblers be whipped. Again, mixing lies with truth. Fact 1. There is no verse nor rule in the Quran which talks about whipping drinkers and gamblers. But to the contrary, we find a verse which talks about whipping the one who accuses people of shameless deeds, such as adultery, without bringing proof or witnesses. Thus, the issue of whipping for any crime is hard unless the person confesses his sin. Fact 2. From the biography of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Muslims extracted the punishment of the drunkard, which is whipping, then letting him free. As for gamblers, the punishment is not whipping in Islamic law, but the Muslim judge chooses a fair punishment for him depending on his case. Fact 3. It is well known how many crimes, accidents, and problems occur because of drunkards. Thus, it is a sin in Islam and it has a punishment. As in the West, if a driver was caught drunk, he might be sent to prison for some time. But remember, weak punishment doesn't treat the problem. Fact 4. The prohibition of wine was not only in Islam, but also in the Bible. Judges chapter 13, verse 4. And now beware, I pray thee, and drink not wine nor strong drink, and eat nothing unclean. Luke chapter 1, verse 15. For he shall be great before the Lord, and he shall drink no wine nor strong drink. And he shall be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb. 9. Sharia allows the husband to hit his wife. The Almighty talks about Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the Quran, saying, Quran, chapter 33, verse 21. In the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, peace be upon him, you have a good example to follow for him who hopes in the meeting with Allah and the last day and remembers Allah much. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, throughout his life never beat a woman, and thus we must take him as a role model. Concerning the rights of women, the Quran said, chapter 4, verse 19, O ye who believe, ye are forbidden to inherit women against their will, nor shall ye treat them with harshness. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, our role model said, narrated Muawiyah al-Quraishi, I went to the Apostle of Allah, peace be upon him, and asked him, What do you say about our wives? Give them food from what you have for yourselves, and clothe them by which you clothe yourself, and do not beat them, and do not revile them. Sunan Abu Dawud, Book 11, Marriage, Kitabu Nikah, Number 2139. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, also said, How does any of you beat his wife as he beats the stallion camel and then embrace her, meaning sleep with her? Al-Bukhari, Hadith 68, page 42 and 43. The Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, Do not beat the female servants of Allah. By Allah, anyone who beats them is not a good person. Al-Bukhari, Chapter 7, page 304. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, also said, The best among you is the one who deals good with his wife. The last statement of the Prophet before he died was, Look after your women. 10. Allow people to exact revenge, an eye for an eye. The author of this video has understood the verse out of context. In context, the verse in the Quran in which the Almighty said, An eye for an eye, was talking about the Jewish law in the past which said, An eye for an eye. See for yourself. The Quran, chapter 5, verse 45. In the Torah, the Old Testament, we made mandatory for the Jews these rules of retaliation, capital punishment for the murder of a person, an eye for an eye, a nose for a nose, an ear for an ear, a tooth for a tooth, and the just compensation for a wound. If the perpetrator is forgiven by the affected party, this will be an expiation of his crime. Let's look in the Bible to see if this statement in the Quran is true about the Jewish law. Deuteronomy, chapter 19, verse 21. Show no pity, life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, foot for foot. You can find the same statement also in Exodus, chapter 21, verse 31, and Leviticus, chapter 24, verse 20. So the author of the video, Three Lies About Islam, must be either ignorant or intentionally misquoting and referring from the Bible and claiming it to be from the Quran. Completing our concise reply, the video, Three Things, Lies About Islam. Let's listen to more of his lies with open minds and you be the judge. 11. Command that a thief's hand must be cut off. First, fact. It should be known that not everyone who steals has his hand cut off. In fact, Islamic law here is talking about a person who is accustomed to stealing and takes it as his job. This is his fair punishment to protect the community from his evil. Second fact. This ruling also depends on the amount he stole. If the person steals a pen, for example, or a piece of cake, obviously, his hands will not be cut off. The law is talking about criminals who are accustomed to stealing, and there is no way of protecting the community except by this. Third fact, when the intensity or harshness of a punishment is relaxed, then no robber will be afraid of the police or the law anymore. You can find, for example, in a country like South Africa, so many crimes like robbery are committed without fear. Why? Because the law is weak. Punishment is relaxed, so the criminals do all kinds of crimes like killing, hijacking, and stealing in a casual manner, afraid of nothing. They know that they will land in prison with five-star benefits, only to come out to steal again, while if they carried out Islamic law, such crimes will end and rarely happen. 12. Ordering an unmarried adulterer and fornicators to be stoned to death. Again, another lie by the author of the video, who again mixes between the Quran and the Bible. In Islam, the punishment of the unmarried people who commit adultery is clear and mentioned in the Quran. Chapter 24, verse 2. Adulteress and the adulterer, you shall whip each of them 100 lashes. Do not be swayed by pity from carrying out God's law. if you truly believe in God and the last day. While in the Bible, the punishment is stoning to death. John chapter 8, verse 5. And said to Jesus, Teacher, this woman was caught in the act of adultery. In the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. Now, what do you say? Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 22. If a man is found sleeping with another woman's wife, both the man who slept with her and the woman must die. You must purge the evil from Israel.